Too many days in the darkness, without a glimpse of the light. Running tired and broken and scared, but I swear I'll never give up the fight. I see you broken and beat, head pulled down over your eyes. Every part of you wants to surrender, darling, you were meant to survive. With every star, we are born again. Open your heart, spend less time in your head. With every star,
father, for my loaded gun. Sometimes I'm at the peak and other times I'm about to fall. Sometimes I gotta wonder what I'm doing here at all. Sometimes in my mind I just sit here and I'm guessing. How can I find the answers? I don't even got the questions. Sometimes I'm at the peak and other times I'm about to fall. Sometimes I gotta wonder what I'm doing here at all. Sometimes in my mind I just sit here and I'm guessing. How can I find the answers? I don't even got the questions. I feel like something's wrong, been sitting way too long. Just sent a couple texts, now I wanna break my phone. Now you can't reply, it's killing me this time. But next time that I'ma see you, I just act like it's all fine. Damn, why we always lie? Why we always play these games? Act like we don't care, but we know we feel the same. Told you last week, now I thought this game was over. But now you can't remember, can we say it when we're sober? No. So I keep pouring tonic, mixing feelings with this drink, and we both know it's getting toxic. I just wanna keep you talking, ignoring all these problems. If this the only way, I just like it when we honest.
Like it when we honest. Yeah. I just like it when we honest. Just like it when we honest, baby. Records and I'll torture your words, and I guess you should have thought about a person. Everything that makes me wrong, remember I'll leave me here, she's leaving me here.
What is up, everybody? We are here finally in the round of four of the ASL, and what a special match we have today.
Oh, special. Well, both special and the most normal everyday match you could ever have. Flash vying for yet another ASL Finals. This guy has played in 8 ASLs. He's won 4 of them. He's been to the finals 5 times, and he's challenging for the 6th time here tonight. It is just unbelievable. The greatest gamer of all time, is, as we always refer to him, and as everyone does, unless they're an idiot. He is an unstoppable force, but can he be stopped? He's going up against Queen tonight, who is
pretty much
unquestionably the strongest Zerg in the world right now.
I think Queen is also not just the strongest Zerg, he's the brainiest Zerg that we have right now.
Yeah.
He's really been an innovator in the super modern era of Zerg plays. The problem for Queen is that Flash really is the greatest gamer of all time.
Yeah.
This is not an exaggeration. We're not saying this because we are StarCraft people and Flash is the best at StarCraft. You can compare him to any other player in any other game.
Yeah. No one compares to him.
Yeah, he's basically like the Floyd Mayweather of StarCraft or something. Like, pretty
but
much.
Floyd Mayweather wishes he was as good at something as Flash is at StarCraft.
Yeah, I'd say Flash is better at. But Floyd Mayweather was pretty good. He's like,
yeah, he's pretty good.
He's like, I boxed my whole life. I don't even have brain damage. I didn't actually get hit in the head enough. And so this is going to be a lot of fun. Now, we've had upsets in ASL in the past, even with Flash. We did see Snow take down Flash before in a best of 5. We could have a repeat of something like that here now. It'll be an uphill fight for Queen, no doubt. But we've seen Zerg players especially become masterful at prepping in best of 5s.
Yeah, and that's very important. In fact, that's the only finals that Flash lost was against Effort in a best of 5, and it was a very well-prepped series full of mind games. I expect to see something similar here tonight. I'm not counting on Queen taking him down because I would never count on anyone taking him down, but he's similar enough to Effort in enough ways that this is an exciting match for anyone in the know.
Now, occasionally we talk about matches like this, hype them up, and then Flash dominates and does not lose the game. So that's also a possibility here.
That's true.
I think the only thing that's out of the question is Queen 3-0-ing. That would be insane.
Yeah, I don't think that would work. How would that work?
I don't even know what that would look like.
Yeah. If we went out and broke Flash's fingers, he'd probably still take a map.
Yeah, he could probably have flippers for hands, and he'd still pretty much go
play on an
3-2.
Xbox controller.
Yeah. This is all pretty commonplace here for Flash to be this far and be expected to advance. As you can see from the fan predictions online, 85% of the people assume that Flash will win. 15% are legally insane. But I'm sure our Queen fans, nonetheless.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Let's see how he does here. Again, we saw it with Snow. Snow played an incredible series, and it was crazy to see Flash be taken down. They're a really special day in ASL. And the competition is still very fierce in StarCraft Remastered. We've got a quick video for you guys, then we'll go to an interview, and then we'll start our best of 5 to find out who will go on to the ASL Season 9 Finals.
ASL Season 9 Refresher.
And we're back here at ASL Season 9, the semifinals of Flash versus Queen, also known as Zero. We will find out who our first finalist is here. It'll be one of these two players. We'll have a short interview with them. To my right is Flash. Flash, you've been in 6 semifinals. Whenever you're in the semifinals, you seem to make it to the finals. A lot of people are expecting you to repeat that once again. What is your predictions coming in here today? I will say this, I don't think it's going to be an easy semifinals at all. That being said, I am very confident. I'll have to show a performance that coincides with my confidence. So I tell everybody at home to watch my games and have high expectations. So to put it simply, there have been a lot of Zerg players in the past that have successfully challenged you. In the quarterfinals against Action, you had a full series, a very close series, and a hard-fought series. You're here against another Zerg now. What do you have to say about that? I think the quarterfinals was an incredible learning experience for me.
그냥 제가 전략 얘기를 좀 하기 그렇고 기대하셔도 좋을 것 같다는 말을 하고 싶습니다.
Wow.
It's hard to talk about my strategies beforehand, but I just say watch carefully and you'll see what I'm going to do. Over to you now, Queen.
오랜만이잖아요. 네. AS에 올라온 데까지 시간도 꽤
걸렸고 It's been a long time.
한번 미끄러지고 난 이후에 올라와서
You face Flash again in a long series.
이영호가 기다리고 있어요. 현재 심정은요?
You've had a tough journey to get here. How do you feel right now? I think facing Flash in the finals, I'd actually think it's actually better for me to face him in the semifinals. So I'm sure you saw that fan prediction, 85% in his favor. And you only had the 15% vote. Sure, but I actually think 15% of people expecting me to advance is pretty good considering who my opponent is. Also, I clearly know what I'm up against. Just based off the objective record that we've seen before. Anyways, I've got confidence.
네.
So both these players have prepped a lot. You're here in the semifinals now. Queen, if you win the first map against Flash, do you think you can carry that to victory in the series? Well, I would say not one-sided necessarily, but I have prepped and I have strategies on all five maps. So I'm not really concerned about the score. I'm worried about overcoming my opponent. Flash going into this match. In terms of ASL, you've lost effort before, but of course that's a different player. But in the semifinals, Zergs have never been a problem for you in the past. Your thoughts going up against Queen? Yeah, I mean, I also know if I got eliminated against a Zerg, then it would be very obvious that Queen is a strong player. But nonetheless, I think this is going to be a tough series. But just like he said, he prepped on all five maps. I have also come in here with plans on all five maps, and I don't think there's any way he'll win on any of those maps easily. I'm also very confident on the fourth and fifth map, especially in the late game. So, your any closing thoughts? Nobody can tell what the results are going to be. All I can say is that I'm ready to show what I prepped. For the people that are watching, keep your expectations high, and I'm going to do my best. And I hope the games are fun too, he says. And you, Flash? Yes, I've also realized that I need to get a better streamlined gameplay against Zerg. I think if I can focus and bring what I prepped here, it's going to be it's going to bring good results, yield good results. So I'm just going to focus from start to finish and win this. Okay, that does it for our interview. I'm super excited to see this. By the way, the round of 8 was, I think, literally, no exaggeration, best round of 8 we've ever had in any StarCraft tournament in the history of the game. This round of 4 could be the same thing. We got a quick video, then we're going to hop into our match. This is Flash vs. Queen, a fight to get to the finals of the ASL Season 9.
ASL 시즌 9 세미 파이널.
So this is a shot of our massive new studio. It's a Jamsil station located below Lotte Tower, the fifth tallest building in the world, the tallest building in Korea. Once coronavirus has been defeated and people can have public gatherings all around the world, obviously here in Korea, come down and check it out. It's really awesome. It's unfortunate that we opened this new studio. We still have the old studio, by the way. We still host events out like GSL out of there. But it's really something worth seeing.
Yeah, it's a very cool area, and we kind of have to have the ASL near such a tall building so we have something to drape the scroll that has Flash's accomplishments on it over. The only thing tall enough in the country, in fact.
Yeah.
Now, this upcoming match, it's very exciting. You saw that interview. You can see that Queen is feeling relatively confident, more confident than most people that go up against Flash.
Yeah. I almost wonder if part of that confidence boost was seeing how Action played. I think that anything that Action can do, Queen can also do.
I think that Queen does it better. I think that Queen is just straight up a better player than Action. Like, I mean, Action's late game is very nice, but Queen has a much stronger mid game, a much stronger early game as well, I would say.
I would agree with that.
Yeah.
He's one of the players that's really engineered some of the most advanced technical openings for Zerg in the modern era. Mm-hmm. He's really shown how exploitative you can be in early game and really punish. He's not afraid to pull the trigger either and do very aggressive attacks.
Sure.
But he's able to do a very long, stretched out late game as well.
Yeah. Yeah. He really is the best Zerg right now, I would say. I think most people agree with that. He's super good. And because, I look at the way that Flash played the series against Action, I don't think the series is going to look anything like it. Flash is very tricky with how he prepares. And, of course, this is kind of, in a funny way, a tough road for Flash because he has the potential of three best of fives against three of the world's best Zergs right in a row in the tournament.
True.
So it's like, what are you going to show and what are you going to do and how are you going to build that forward? But, of course, we have on Tuesday Light versus Chosham Zerg to see who will play against the winner of tonight.
That's right. It's going to be another great TVZ. Definitely, you know, if you're trying to learn this matchup on either side, this is going to be your week. We are moments away from starting this. Mm-hmm. Map 1 will be on match point. Again, it's very obvious that Flash is the clear favorite, but people are continuing to improve out here. I think occasionally people that don't really follow StarCraft kind of make up their own narrative or follow what they read on Reddits where people post stuff that they don't, who also don't really follow or know what's going on, and people assume that it's just Flash dominating and nobody else is playing or the competition isn't fierce. It could not be farther from the case. The games have been really close, and although Flash has continued his reign of terror and dominance in StarCraft in Korea, there's been so many moments the throne has almost been taken from him. We saw Snow defeat him in a previous ASL, and we've had some close calls. Frankly, had Action's Ling all in on match point not been spotted about a second earlier.
Yeah, you would have been out.
I think that we would be sitting here casting Action versus Queen.
Yeah, that I would agree with that, absolutely. He has had a few close calls here and there. Like, even though he is the best player in basically every regard, you can plan series that can do very well against him. And that's an important thing to keep in mind. Like, that is how, for instance, Effort beat him in the finals of ASL. It was all planned out very, very well. Some of his most notable losses that he's had have actually been against Zergs that planned very well. Like, Saxry, in a previous early round, took some games off Flash. And, well, a game off Flash where, specifically, he did a very cool burrow play to catch the Vulture of Flash when Flash was going for unit light composition, and he just, you can plan things like this around the way that Flash plays, but the thing is, he's such a sophisticated player that he alters how he's going to play. For instance, he single-handedly won the KCM finals, you know, the team battle, like King of the Hill, Terran versus Zerg versus Protoss tournament that goes on out in Korea. It was a 4-4 finals between Zerg and Terran. Protoss had been eliminated already, and Flash all killed the Zerg team. Right, and this was like a day or two before he played Action. And then he came in and played completely different builds against Action in every game. And played different builds during KCM in all the games. So it's like, this guy has such a deep range. Action didn't play, by the way, on the other side. This is the kind of mindset I want people to understand. Like, Action doesn't want to show his games. Flash is like, I'll show games, but it won't be the right information. right? And then he still beats all the world's best Zergs, moves on, beats Action. Here he is. What's he going to show? Is it going to look like what he did in KCM? Is it going to look like what he did against Action? The thing is, he has a wider range than that even. Like, he can do any build. He made most of the builds.
Yeah, and what's crazy about it as well is that it's not just his execution, which, you know, mechanically he's perfect. It's that he's able to harvest so much data out of everybody else's playstyle to figure out where the meta needs to go next.
Yes.
And so he's rarely ever in a situation where people have mapped him out and, you know, he has to then have his playstyle beaten in order to transition it to something new. He's always recreating himself, reinventing.
That's a really good thing to say, and we'll talk more about that in a second. Just real quick, Flash banned Inner Coven, Queen banned Escalade. A little bit interesting on the Escalade ban, but not that big. Matchpoint, Horizon, Polypoid, Neo Sylphid, Hitchhiker. Map 2 will probably be the hardest one for Flash. Horizon seems to be one where it matters heavily upon spawn positions. So we'll see where they spawn on that and how he handles that map. But Matchpoint, the first map, generally a map that we're going to see high aggression from Zerg on. But I'm sorry, you said something right before and I really wanted to expand upon it. Well,
I was talking about how Flash is reinventing the meta, and he look at what other players are doing and trends on the ladder,
even in
matchups that are not his, and kind of see what needs to be done next,
yes.
Which is really, really hard to do. You know, it's hard enough to keep up with the meta.
Yeah.
You know, the competition's so fierce, and the fact that he'll come in here with something totally different. I mean, he really seems to understand the game better than I think we've seen pretty much any player understand any game.
Yes, I think that's the right way to put it. That's his superpower.
Some people will knock on StarCraft because it's old. Those people are idiots. But, you know, you have to have a game that's been around for a long time to have a story that's this complex and this history.
The game hasn't been patched in, like, 20 years.
Yeah.
And it just, the meta is changing quicker than ever at this point. And he's a big part of the reason. And it's so true. There was a notable interview on TeamLiquid.net that he gave where he's like, oh yeah, this build I was doing, I believe it was a 1-1-1 he was talking about, which is Barracks Factory Starport opener, which is a very complex, difficult build to play already. He said that it started to drop a few percentage points in his matches for the win rate, and he knew he had to innovate something new at that point because that means that people are starting to catch on to how he's doing it.
Right.
And we saw him try to use some very innovative builds against Action. They didn't work out that well, like the one Factory Goliath into Bioplay, which is kind of, there's been a bit of a hubbub about that. Didn't really work out super well against Action, and I don't think he'll do it against Queen because Queen has the mid-game killer instinct that Action lacks. So.
Okay. Yeah, I like that.
I was really thinking about it today. What types of builds are we going to see today from Flash? And I think that there's three different styles that we might see today. 8-racks builds, regular bio builds, and 1-1-1s. I don't think we'll see Goliath builds here. I don't think that we'll see
really, you think no
Goliath into
builds?
Bio. I don't think we're going to see Goliath builds. Just Goliath builds, I think, on the Terran side, there's not enough skill differentiation.
One thing I'm wondering is how much standard play is Queen going to have trying to tech into link game and get defilers up, or how much weird play are we going to have? Because we saw this for a while, I think specifically, why am I suddenly forgetting our observer's name who got to the ASL finals?
Shine,
thank you. I don't know why I suddenly forgot his name. I'm actually good
okay.
friends with him. Shine.
Not that good, apparently.
I don't know what's... Sorry, his brain fart there. Shine, you know, introduced a lot of very weird Zerg 2-base builds.
Yeah.
Unusual drop timings, surprise lurker switches, a lot of Ling all-ins, Hydra bus, and that's proven off and on to be incredibly successful in taking out... Terrence, who are very good. I don't know if it's going to work against Flash, but I'm curious to see if Queen's going to introduce that.
Yeah, it's hard to say how Queen is going to approach
this. Seems more like something Shine or Jadong would be likely to do. Queen and Action are either good. They seem to be more Ling all in or just macro up. Anyways, we're out of time. Game one is ready. Flash versus Queen starts now. The winner goes on to the finals of the ASL Season 9.
매치포인트에서 게임을 시작합니다.
Okay, so Flash is in the upper right. Queen is in the bottom left. This is a one-on-one map, so we'll see if there's any very special strategies that you can only do on these one-on-one maps come out. I don't think we're going to have anything too special, but just something to note here. Out of all the other maps we have, this is the one where if someone's going to do something like that, it'll be here.
Yeah, it could be. It could be. You know, I think it's a map that Terran is going to fare pretty well on after the very early game. And even the very early game is not going to be too tough. Like, where we see the Overlord right now, that's kind of this great place to micro mutalists back and forth in. That's actually, you know, we see a fair amount of Goliath build on this map because of that, because two Atri mutalists can be so strong. We gotta wait a minute here and see where these guys want to end up going.
One other feature on this map is that your natural, for instance, for the Terran, when the Terran does take that, it's on level ground. There's a lot of pushes and attacks. We've seen, not a lot, but we've seen stuff where people rush into Hydras to surprise Terrans and try to kill them. It is bendable, but just want to put some of these ideas out here because we really don't know what kind of series we're going to have so far.
These are Flash's round of, the round of eights? No, where's Jadon? This is two. That was a round of eight match, right? Not round four.
I can't remember, actually.
I'm pretty darn sure. Anyways, whatever. Match point, we see it has a slight winning advantage for Terran here. Looks like regular barracks opening from Flash. We do not see a gas. Yep. So it looks like just a regular bio open. Probably just right into expansion. You won't normally do anything one base off of something like this. Kind of as expected.
We're waiting for Queen to throw down the hatchery at the natural, which will be coming in here pretty soon. But we have a gas made before the second hatchery.
Yeah,
so this
looks
to be a very quick layer tech.
It's the 12 pool, 12 hatch type of play.
Uh-oh.
His SCV's going to get here. He's going to know immediately what this
is. Okay, this is actually already a little bit annoying here for the Zerg. Now, he will be able to get the eBay and then finally get the hatcheries thrown down here. But this is a little bit of an interruption here for Flash. I'm sorry, for Queen.
Yeah, it's definitely a bit annoying. The Ling's coming across the map. He's already making his bunker, though. And normally against something like this, you are going to try to get up into your academy very quickly. You're going to try to get up into your academy tech very, very quickly. A lot of times, pros will skip that second barracks against this type of play just to make sure that they get everything on time for the mutas. See, that's a very quick layer.
And so if I'm seeing this right, Artosis, I mean, he's just going to go for quick mutas, try to harass, try to do a lot of damage early on, and just keep Terran oppressed and stuck in his base.
Absolutely. Well, that's normally what you'll see, but of course, we have to wait and see if he wants to do something like throw down a Hydralisk Den for some Lurker play. It's not as likely because it doesn't really have any sort of staying power. It's just like a tricky all-in two-hatchery Lurker.
And any two-hatchery lurker, I mean, it doesn't allow you to extend the game, usually at least. Occasionally we'll see Sulky do some pretty crazy stuff, but usually you can't get into late game, you know. Okay, mutas are just such a stronger, more robust bet.
Yeah. So you see he's really focusing on nailing that wall. Even puts a Marine outside the bunker. You might look at that and say, wait a minute, the Marine is weaker than the bunker. Don't you want inside? No, it blocks Ling pathing. So just a very, very turtled position for Flash right now.
There's two SCVs on the map.
Yes.
What is your thoughts on that? I mean, we have one. It looks like he's going to send both out at the same time. Is he going to try to run one through that can just soak damage while the other one actually can get inside the main?
Yeah, I think he needs to know if lurkers are on the way.
Okay, this is no suck at calling.
It's not just that. It's like a little bit about the Lings, too, but you really need to know if they're going lurker or they're going spire. And he is going to get this in and see that, in fact, it is Spire, which then he'll just, like, nail his game plan because this is what you expect.
Yeah.
But if it's Lurker and you have your wall up and you're not ready for it, you can actually just die.
Bunch of turrets in your main being made. Yeah, absolutely. It's a very easy way to lose. You know, Zerg always have the first to any fast expanding race. Whoa. Wait.
Oh, okay. He threw down a Hydralisk then as it was coming back. Flash, actually, I don't think got to see it. And then it got canceled anyways.
So
I believe that's what has occurred here.
That happened a little bit too quickly for me.
Oh my god, this is a wild build. He is rushing to Valkyrie.
Yeah, with an armory and a starport.
Yeah.
And a floating factory. That all points to Valkyrie here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, it's correct me if I'm wrong here. It's three Scourge hits to kill a Valkyrie, right?
It's two.
It's two still. Okay.
I wish it was three. My god.
No,
my TVZs would go a lot better, Tasteless.
Is there any air unit where it's three hits to kill so that
three,
maybe?
I don't think anything. Maybe a
I mean,
scout?
Besides like a carrier. Yeah, I don't know.
I think a scout,
I always thought
maybe
there was one unit that took three. But, yeah. So, this actually, in some ways, almost for what Flash is doing, looks like a Protoss fast expanding against a Zerg, you know, where they're going to get Corsairs.
Yeah.
One easy way to just die is if they just hit your Corsair with Scourge and then get over the Stargate. And it seems like we have the same ideas
that
could be at play here.
So, yeah, basically he knows that this is a slightly lower economy Mutalisk play, and this is really funny because Zero is turning that on its head. I'll talk about that in just a second, but he wants to get the Valkyries out to really shut down the Mutas, and then he will explode into a huge amount of bile.
Now,
this is hilarious,
pretty
actually.
Well covered. You know, everything is just positioned well enough. I don't know that he's going to see this.
Dude.
Now, when you see that, see how the armory is?
You think that's Valkyrie, I think.
Okay, yeah. I was going to say, like,
that couldn't be a vessel, and you're upgrading
like
from
a dropship.
And you went drop, and you went for the fast expand. Like, you know, those things, like, it's just a bit too much gas.
So, one of the things about the Valkyrie, and, you know, back before we were casting StarCraft II initially, you know, when we had basically had to walk away from StarCraft 1 for a while because we were all focused on StarCraft 2 and getting work out here. Most people left StarCraft 1 going into StarCraft 2 assuming the Valkyrie was not really a viable unit.
Yeah.
And Flash has basically proven that it actually can be quite viable.
Yeah.
You just have to know how to control it, and I don't know. If you know how to explain this, I don't.
I can explain in just a minute.
Sure.
But first I want to mention that Queen has just completely tricked Flash out. Because he went for the really quick pool and gas into really quick Mutas. He's barely made Mutas here, and he double expanded. So right now, Flash is sitting here on two Valkyries, where literally he doesn't even need one, because there's three Mutas and two Scourge on the map. And Zero going immediately up to four bases in Lurker Tech. He's trying to heavily counter the counter to his build.
Yeah, this is really smart. Now, there is a small amount of bio coming out here that's being escorted by the Valkyries. He's made some more Mutas back at home now. By the way, two expansions up at once for Queen.
This is
pretty bold play. He will have to defend this with an army and not with static defense.
Yeah,
it's very important to note.
There's three locations that Flash can hit with this bio.
Yeah.
So
you can't just make sunks at all those.
You need to get Lurkers out, which is why I think he made more Mutas, because he needs to buy some more time.
Right.
Even if it's the cost-efficient Mutas, which I don't think he actually wanted to make, but is forced into it here.
Okay, poor control there by Queen.
Oh, God. Yeah, Flash, like, he has, like, his army kills Mutas so badly that if he just walks across the map, he will kill at least one base.
Yeah. Now, I imagine...
Four Valks.
Yeah, this is kind of crazy. Now, I have to imagine there's going to be a lot more Lings being made here. You need to have enough on the ground. Okay, this is going to be crazy. Because, this air can just get melted. Now, occasionally, Mutas get a good engage where they just take out the air fast enough.
Yeah, poor Valks, that's not going to happen. He's going to just murder us.
Hold on, Scourge coming through here, connecting with some of those Valkyries.
Yeah, and he's got a lot of Lings, so he's actually cleaning relatively well. But as you can see, the Valkyries doing a lot of heavy lifting here against the Mutas.
Okay, so he does come through. I imagine there's going to be some more Lings coming. Now, all these Mutas are very badly damaged. So again, a few extra missiles connecting with these Mutas, and they all go down. He just barely seems to not have enough with more Marines coming through.
Wow. Really some amazing play here on both sides. So many mind games have actually gone on this game. And, like, I think that Queen's idea was very, very smart to try to rush into maybe Lurkers from here. I think that's what his plan was. Maybe it was just for the late Mutas. But the amount of Valkyries made by Flash and the fact that he moved out before Lurkers could truly be ready, just beautiful execution, and he's done a ton of damage already.
Now, it's still three bases here. And, three bases is what Zerg needs. I mean, losing the mineral is out of all the bases he could lose, that's the one that I guess is the most acceptable to have a loss there. Now these Scourge are coming through here. They're going to connect. One does connect with its desired target. We need some more Lings, though, if Zerg's going to be able to take this on the ground.
Ooh. He nails both those relatively quickly. And GG's. Okay. Not a big surprise with the GG there, since he did take so much damage and really had nothing left. But that was like, I think that Zero had a great strategy here once again, just to point that out. But then Flash pressured so heavily, and the fact that he like scans, sees the Hydralis Den, sees that it's like four bases, and then continues to make Valkyries shows the depth of his understanding. Because there, I think a lot of Terrans will look in and be like, well, Valkyries are really bad against Lurker tech generally, so you don't want to overmake them. You want to try to get into maybe tank, maybe Vessel, but instead he makes more, realizing that if you don't make Mutas, you're instantly dead.
Yeah. And also, you know, if you don't have enough Mutas out and you don't have the Lurker tech out in time, the Valkyries will go kill all your Overlords after they kill the Mutas. Mm-hmm. And then it's just like one of these things where you're, you know, for a while soft locked out of production, and that's going to be enough time for a Terran to just kill you. Again, actually a great first game, but Flash seeming to be prepared, gracefully techs through what Zerg did. I like the four bases at once, but I think if Terran hits that timing just right enough, and I think you need just a few more Lings in that fight. If you have maybe six more Lings.
Well, I want to point out, because the replay was brought up by our observer over on my screen, and when Flash was moving out, Queen was at 30 drones against 33 SCVs, which shows that he was really powering greedily.
We're going to go to a break. When we come back, game two with Flash versus Queen. Don't go away.
멋지다. 아, 진짜 멋지다. 와, 4강까지 올라갈 줄 알았어요, 진짜?
아, 몰랐어요.
아니, 근데 나는 약간 24강 때부터 박상현 선수가 굉장히 자신감이 있어 보이는 거야.
우승이 아니면 24강 때가 있었어요. 지금도 있어요.
오. 근데 손을 막 바들바들 아직 떨고 있는데.
아, 또 재밌는 경기 보여줘서 수능증 있어가지고
발을 못 떨고 있는데. 아, 근데 오늘은 진짜 떨만도 했어요. 아니, 다른 상대도 아니고 김태경 선수잖아요. 어떻게 보면 저그한테는 진짜 좀 상징적인 선수잖아요.
그렇죠. 선거전 제일 잘하고 또 진짜 전설이죠. 전설인데 근데 한 번도 안 떨렸는데 2대2 되니까 떨리더라고요. 2대2 되니까 도저히 게임을 못 하겠더라고요.
솔직히 캐논러시 당했을 때 좀 그때 진짜 멘붕 왔죠?
캐논러시 당하기 전까지는 진짜 멘탈 아주 잘했어요. 네. 어떤 훈차했고 이기면 되겠는데.
나 성공만 하면 이거 그냥 끝낼 수 있지 않습니까? 저 마지막 멘붕 왔거든요. 네. 진짜
잘했습니다. 진짜 깜짝 놀라가지고. 네, 근데 운이 좋았네요, 진짜.
의뢰를 가려고 준비했었다고.
아, 예.
그런 얘기를 제가 들었어요. 공부를 굉장히 잘했나 봐.
아니, 별로 잘하는 건 아니고 가기 위해서 노력을 했었죠.
아, 그래도 그런 이렇게 목표 설정 자체를 그렇게 딱 의대로 정했다는 게 어느 정도 좀 이렇게 가능성을 봤으니까.
네, 봤어요. 가능성.
그래?
사람들은 뭐 나도 그러면 의대 가고 싶어하면 의대 지망생 이런 식으로 말하더라고.
나도 배우 지망생. 네. 웃어? 이재원 선수한테 한마디 해주세요.
재호 형, 그때와는 다를 겁니다.
기다리세요.
파이팅! AS 시즌 9. 울트라 기어로 부드럽게 이긴다. LG 울트라 기어 게이밍 모니터.
칠성사이다가 좋아요.
울트라 기어로 선명하게 이긴다. LG 울트라 기어 게이밍 모니터.
뭐야?
오빠가 맞춰.
핫식스잖아.
그냥 핫식스가 아니야. 핫식스 거품이라고.
뭐야, 색깔이 하나 더 있네, 릴리야?
핫식스 거품 펀치야.
이거 무슨 맛인데? 뭐 과일 맛 나는 거야, 이거?
이건 열대 과일 맛이 나서 여자들이 굉장히 좋아한다고.
과일만 나면서 되게 상큼한데?
울트라 기어로 선명하게 이긴다. LG 울트라 기어 게이밍 모니터.
Welcome back to ASL. Good first game. I'm a little bit worried we might have a short series, though. I'm hoping Queen can come out with some wins here.
Well, I think the games will all be medium length because these two are going to be striving to gain a gigantic advantage before the late game because that's important at this level, I think.
Excuse me.
Now, I think the games can be, like, I think it was a very interesting strategy on both sides. Flash's strategy made a lot of sense the more I think about it. Where he's kind of trying to cover up any weakness he might have against what Queen's strengths are. Like, if you go just pure bio, Queen might outmicro you that game. Like, he might just nail it and win with that. But the fact that you have Valkyries, it's like, it becomes a little bit more of a math problem.
Yeah.
Where it's like, I have four Valkyries. You know, that's just going to clear Mutas. That's it.
Right,
it's just
right.
The Mutas are going to die, so you're going to have to do something else. And he's kind of forcing Queen into a different position because of that.
I love that we got to see that Valkyrie play too. I want to point out too, had Queen not spotted that in time, that also gets very awkward. When you get up to the 11 mutas and then you get sprayed down.
Oh God, yeah.
Where you're like, oh.
Yeah. It's a good build. That build isn't used all that much, but every now and then the pros will bust that out against
By the way, if you're a beginner, I recommend not just messing with that build until you really know how to control Valkyries. Artosa says there's some videos online that show how to do
that.
Valkyries are very easy to actually bug out. They're like Sky Dragoons or something. Like it's if you're not used
they
to
get locked
them,
in their animation, and there's a trick to make them slide, and we saw Flash actually did not even do it.
Yeah.
Like he had enough Valks that it almost didn't matter. Well, if you screw up while you're doing it, they don't fire. And then you're like, oh, that's even
or their
worse,
missiles,
maybe.
Or their missiles aren't going in the right spot. You see the missiles like actually loop in circles.
Normally those will eventually hit, but yeah.
Game two on Horizon is ready. Our ZBT continues on with Flash versus Queen. Game 준비 완료.
Horizon 달기지에서 게임을 시작합니다.
So we have over here in the bottom Flash, and then on the right side, close by air, it's Queen.
Okay, so this is going to be a lot of fun.
We have not seen this yet in ASL, these spots.
So on this map, it is possible to be. Kind of reminds me of Lost Temple, actually. Long, long ago.
Oh, yeah.
Where you'd both spawn at the bottom left. And, and then you'd have these kind of weird games where it's like, oh, we're like a screen length away as far as air attacks
tough.
And drops go. Mm-hmm. Especially if you do a ZVZ where you both just scout each other and it's like, all right, there's got to be a right way to play this. And so a lot of maps don't allow for these positions as much, but I'm glad with this map now we get to see it reintroduced again. The fact that there is big pressure that can happen in any matchup on either side, right? I mean, you can definitely put Muta pressure on them, but there's always the threat of Terran dropping as the game goes on. So let's see if that plays a role here. I would have, now, just real quick before they start to do whatever they planned,
a lot of players, because air would be so strong, we could see, again, some trick plays here from Queen to go for a less efficient tech to surprise flash. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think we're going to have it, but I just want to start to cover all of our bases here.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, the Overlord is actually going to come in and show itself. I think Queen thinks he was spotted. Not 100% sure if he was, but whatever. Close by air spawns. The Mutalisk is just going to be unbelievably powerful here, because you can go from harassing the main base to defending your own base very, 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 very quickly, whereas the ground army of Terran has to walk for approximately 2.3 years to get back and forth between those 2 locations. Yeah, so that means what we should be seeing out of Flash is flying units. Or, I mean, well, he's not gassing, so I think it's actually going to be like the same build as last game.
Now, you know, it's a rare moment in certain matchups where you see that one race really has a great opportunity to tech first into something that's going to be strong. And I always like, you know, even though people occasionally complain about balance, I really like seeing moments like mm-hmm. this to see how the very best player in any race in the whole world does this.
Yeah.
Because you really get to see how builds can be optimized. So the Overlord is going to fly over the high ground area to spot. And we now have the layer. Now, this is a layer that started after the second hatchery started, so it's not as quick as a game one layer.
This is a very quick layer, though. Like, very, very quick.
Regardless, it's very fast.
Yeah, this is... he's going to have to make a bunker right away from this, I think. And it's going to be a little bit of a tricky game for Flash, because the mutas are going to pop out at an unbelievably early moment, and they're going to get to his base so quickly as well. So I feel like we're going to see Flash have to turtle up pretty heavily, but... guess let's see what the plan is here. Now, so that is, see how early that gas is too? Yeah. I think it's a Valk rebuild.
So you're going to have to indulge me here, because I got a couple questions.
Yeah.
Especially in spots like this, I'm just going to, you know, I'm a Protoss player, so this is not going to be my expertise. But one of the things I'm wondering is it at all possible to go for Wraiths to try to just match them?
Normally, like, some people would go for Wraiths in this position. And
so it is feasible?
You kind of can, but normally you will have wanted to open with a 1-1-1. Here, Cloak would be a little bit late. It would be, like, after the Mute is already in your base. So that's, I think that's not... I don't think that that's the right play here for Flash. And I think especially against Queen, it's not the right play, because his micro is too good and his base is too close anyway. So if they're, like, cross-map, the Wraiths will be better.
Okay.
Because it'll be harder for them to get Overlords down there early.
Okay, next question.
Yeah.
Because you're so close by air here for mm-hmm. Zerg, you can reinforce with mutas very quickly. We see, and again, I know this is coming from, you know, a PvZ perspective, but it's actually the same idea that Protoss tried to do, the Terran's trying to do, which is to get an anti-air out quickly here, mm-hmm. right? The Valkyrie to come out. Now, it's not to scout like the Corsair is, but still, same principles apply. Zerg have all-ins... or all-in-ish stuff they can do, where they just mm-hmm. fly in there with Scourge, dive bomb on the Corsair, kill any defense, and then they're over the Stargate, in this case, mm-hmm. or in this case, it'd be the Barracks or the Starport. Is there any threat of some kind of snowballing attack from Zerg here to try to close it out? Because you can get your mutas in there so fast, you can get more Scourge in there so quickly.
Not as much.
Okay.
I mean, once you break through the initial turrets, then the snowballing does occur. But, like, you can see Flash already adjusts his EVA timing.
By the way.
Yeah, he's going to Factory Goliath, it looks like, this game. I thought he might go for the Valkyrie, but, like, this will defend reasonably well.
I'm very excited about this.
Yeah, he's playing so defensively here. Like, where he put his factories, it's going to take longer to scout, and they're so deep. You can't really get on top of them.
Yeah, I think a lesser player would have put the two factories above the mm-hmm. command center in a more comfortable spot. But, you know, here, this is so turtle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
We need to see and confirm that the mutas are actually going to see this, because this is, I think he might suspect it, but still. You know, just...
Okay, you see where that eBay is? Okay, he actually...
Well, if you lift that off, I think that gives it away as well.
But the thing is, he might want him to think that this is a one factory Goliath.
He
flew in? Now Queen has all sorts of information. He's doing a little bit of damage as well, but he sees, okay, this is a regular Goliath build, not one of these one Goliath in the bio builds, or one factory Goliath in the bio builds.
Now,
I'm surprised
from the Zerg's perspective, Yeah, I'm a little bit surprised by that as well. Is he going to be able to get three out? Sometimes it's crazy how much damage the mutas will take and then all get out in the red. It's one of the reasons why you see people bunch them up by adding an overlord on the other side of the map into the control group.
Okay, this is mind games upon mind game stasis.
Tell
you
me.
You see that flashing eBay? He is going to go into bio from here. See, I thought he was faking him out by having that there, but then he flew in and saw two factories. Because okay, so here, I'm sorry. I'm speaking
Dude,
very technically.
These drone rallies are killing me.
Terran is my life, basically. So basically there's this new build out that Sari showed everybody. Where you go one factory Goliath into bio, because two factory Goliath openings are very strong, and you go into a regular mech game from there.
Right.
Now, there used to be an old build that was, like, really old, where it was two factory Goliath into bio. But that doesn't exist anymore, because one factory Goliath into bio works, so it's just more powerful.
Okay.
Here, it looked like he was faking the one factory Goliath into bio, and then Zero actually flew all the way in, saw the eBay wasn't making, saw the second factory, so he should probably discount this build. Discount the bio. Maybe he'll end up seeing that Academy flashing or something, but yeah, this is it's very tricky. There's a lot of back and forth mind games, and a lot of this matters on what they scout and what they feel in the game, too.
And keep in mind, you know, bio versus pure Goliaths, it requires completely different play styles. So, like,
yes. Yeah, this is such an important point, Tasis, if I could, real quick.
Please.
Basically, if they are going Goliaths, you can stay on pure Muta. And if you do nothing but make mutas off three gasses against pure Goliaths, actually kill them.
Yeah.
Especially on the first move out that they have. But the thing is, mass muta against those Goliaths with bio under it, they can't actually engage because the Goliaths hit them from far away, so they cannot kite the bio. And then the bio has too high DPS to do a full engagement.
It's the most extreme
so they cover
anti-air
each other.
Ever.
Yeah.
And the push timings come out here.
And he's making a lot of mutas. So that is a problem for Queen.
We do have the armor upgrade, which is pretty standard. When you see that they're going mech, you have to be able to have enough to tank damage with your mutas. But I think he realizes now the attack's coming out. Now, there was a few scans sprinkled on the hatcheries of flashes on the queen side of the base. And so he saw mutas hatching everywhere, so I think he's probably pretty confident.
Yeah, he's going to do a counterattack. This is a really smart move, and this action did against him when he did the same build on this map and made Flash turn around. Flash is not turning around this time. He's not making the same mistake twice.
Okay, so he's going to come in here. He has complete rain. And this is pretty crazy. Sunken colonies and an insane number of them are going to be what you need if you're going to hold off Goliath with Medic Marine here. Mm-hmm. Now he's flying back out. He did an incredible amount of damage into the main here. The Sunks are starting. Does he actually have enough, though, over here? I mean, this is a lot of mutas.
It's a lot of mutas. You're right about that. And the two Sunkens are on the way.
So he's got one large clump down here fighting the Goliaths, a smaller clump here being microed against the infantry. The Sunk does finish. Goliaths, by the way, terrible units against Sunken colonies.
That's for sure.
And it seems like the muta number is high enough that it's just Goliaths remaining now.
Well, more reinforcements are coming up, but I think the muta's still going to actually win this. They are getting whittled down a bit, though.
Yeah, they're getting softened up, but, I mean, that's three bases, three gasses, by the way, and no turret defense. And I think Queen can actually seesaw the attention back into the main here again.
Yeah, this is looking real good for Queen right now. He's going to get back in here. The turrets are not remade. Yeah. Flash's economy is garbage. He has no additional tech. He's in trouble.
Yeah, kind of weird movement there from the mutas for a second. But, you know, just like we see in StarCraft 2 and say this a lot, if you get over, it's same thing in StarCraft 1. If you get over their production and you're just able to, I mean, everything that Terran makes dies very quickly when it comes out.
Yeah.
And Terran units need to be together.
Terran is about critical masses and micro.
Yeah. And so he does that. He's done a lot of damage. The army's going to continue to roam here. And this is a wrecking ball of mutas. Like, there is no, you know, finesse here for Terran. He just is going to wipe this out, and he'll be diving back into this location we have a shot of right over here.
It's Queen's game to lose at this point. He's in complete control. He's done everything so well here. And, I mean, Flash is in so much trouble. He's got so few SCVs. He's just making bio and Goliaths. That's it.
I actually think Queen's going to take this game.
Yeah,
we've got ourselves
over,
a series.
Man.
Yeah, GG. Queen's done it. We're tied up 1-1. And again, these Zergs are showing to be a real threat. to Flash.
Well, you see the strength as well of those close spawns in that game. Flash went as heavily anti-muta as he could. But the mutas, they did a lot of damage to the SCVs. They cleaned out a bunch of turrets and then turned around and got home in time to defend the big push of Flash. So Flash didn't even get to kill a base. Maybe if he kills the natural there, it's still a game, right? But unable to even do that. Great play from Queen.
Yeah, good decision making. He knew when to attack it to the main, and then he knew when to go back. And let me tell you something. That Sunken Colony, those mutas, you know, don't get in there in time, or Queen doesn't control that perfectly, the natural goes down and Flash wins. So excellent play. We're already seeing so many mind games actually on both sides here from these players. This
is
a great series.
There's a ton of mind games going on, and definitely mind games that we do not know about as well.
That's true.
These guys stream all the time. They're both very famous, know each other well. They've practiced with the same group of friends and fellow pro gamers. So I'm sure there's a lot behind the scenes that we cannot even eliminate.
Oh, for sure. So we've got ourselves a series. It's not going to be a 3-0 here. Flash has been taken out in game one here. He had a hard time against Action. Queen, maybe even better. Maybe he'll take this. We'll find out, though. Game three is just around the corner. Don't go away.
Ultra기어로 부드럽게 이긴다. LG 울트라기어 게이밍 모니터.
마법의 음료 하식스는 마시게 되면은 엔돌핀이 확 돌면서 머리에 수분이 공급되고 그리고 내가 바로 한 모금만 마셔도 뭔가 알 거야. 100ml 늘어났고 마시게 되면 진짜 마법의 음료. 신제품 빨간색. 어?
반칙 아닙니까? 그것은 전설의 음료 하식스.
먹을 때 하식스 많이 마시자. 진짜 괜찮지.
맛있다 이거.
파랑색, 빨강색 맛 여러분들 많이들 진짜 마셔주시고 진짜로 거짓말 안 치고 맛있습니다.
울트라 기어로 선명하게 이긴다. LG 울트라 기어 게이밍 모니터.
너무 많이 마셨다.
청정제주 숙취 비법과 탄산의 만남. 숙취엔 깨스강.
지금은 저그가 점령하고 있는 아스트라드 3 단장의 능선. 이곳은 2000년대 초부터 2300년대까지 관광지로 굉장히 유명한 장소였지만 지금은 야생 저그의 천국이 됐습니다. 때문에 평상시에 보기 힘든 저그들을 관찰하기 아주 좋은 곳이기도 하죠. 하하, 마침 여기에 굉장히 희귀한 저그가 보입니다. 퀸입니다. 위협을 느끼면 상대의 발을 묶는 점액질을 뿜어대기 때문에 포착하기 굉장히 힘든 저그 중 하나죠. 둥둥 떠다니는 우산처럼 생긴 퀸은 저그 종족에서 가장 신비로운 개체입니다. 비록 다른 곤충 군체의 여왕들과 달리 번식 기능은 없지만 퀸에게는 다 계획이 있습니다. 퀸은 굉장히 독특한 기생충들을 몸에 품고 있습니다. 귀인의 영광으로도 불리는 페로사이트를 사용하면 자신이 보유한 기생충을 다른 존재에게 흡착시킬 수 있는데 삐뚤어진 존경심으로 숙주에게 꼭 붙어서 숙주가 보는 모든 것을 귀인에게 정보로 제공해 줍니다. 이 기생충은 숙주가 죽어야지만 완벽히 제거되기 때문에 감염된 이들의 말로는 영 좋지 않습니다. 브루드링이라는 기생충에 감염된다면 더욱 끔찍한 최후를 기다리는 수밖에 없죠. 브루드링은 살아있는 모든 생물체를 숙주로 삼고 숙주의 몸을 내부에서부터 집어삼킨 후 부화합니다. 퀸의 자식들인 셈이죠. 정상적인 번식 능력은 없지만 퀸이라 불리기엔 부족함이 없는 것은 바로 이런 특수한 능력 덕분입니다. 퀸이 가진 가장 독특한 능력은 반파된 테헤란 커맨드 센터를 만났을 때 드러납니다. 퀸은 부서진 커맨드 센터에 몰래 잠입해 자신의 갑각을 재단에 만든 위장 마린 군복으로 SCV 조종사들을 유혹합니다. 그렇게 한번 입으면 결코 벗을 수 없는 군복을 입는 순간 감염된 테헤란으로 다시 태어나게 됩니다. 이들은 기본적으로 뇌가 감염된 상태이기 때문에 지능이 매우 떨어지지만 그 폭발의 위력이 워낙 어마어마하기 때문에 위기의 적의 입장에서는 일발 역전을 노릴 수 있는 재원이기도 합니다. 때문에 반파된 커맨드 센터에 잠입하는 일은 모든 퀸이 간절히 그리는 꿈과 같은 것이죠. 오늘도 코프룰루 구역 어딘가에서 퀸은 꿈을 꿉니다. 이루어지기 어려운 꿈이기에 감염된 테란의 폭발은 더 아름답나 봅니다.
울트라 기어로 선명하게 이긴다. LG 울트라 기어 게이밍 모니터.
What's up, everybody? We're tied up 1-1. Thank God. I was really hoping for a close series. We saw in the last game two Factory Goliath, Tekken to Goliaths. He was doing a really good job masking it, though, like hiding it very well, Flash was.
Yeah.
Then he switches into Bio, which is like the ultimate anti-air. But, of course, the strength of Mutas is that they can pretty much get anywhere in a couple seconds on the map. And so he was able to counterattack into the main, do an incredible amount of damage, just barely get the defenses up in time to then swing back, defend the push, to then come back and punish once more. And it was a hole that Flash just couldn't dig his way out of, so he concedes, and here we go into game three. A big theme that's been happening here today is how is Terran going to address Mutatech? You know, we saw in actions games, he was interested in some of them and ended it very quickly, trying to basically take the Terran out when the Terran's still weak. Here, it seems like Flash is very aware that Queen's Mutalisk tech is a threat. He basically has the best Muta control ever.
It's him and Choshim Zerg, really.
Yeah.
Like, they are really scary with the Mutalisk.
And so, Flash is, you know, playing some of the mind games of his own, but I think Queen, with really good positional play, flushed him out. But, you know, that was a unique position we had on the last map. Very close by air here for Zerg, something that Queen could exploit. Polypoid is a different map entirely.
Oh, yeah.
All four printers, the four spawns, so we can't have the same situation as before. And anyways, our game is ready. Let's go to game three and see how Flash for Queen plays out.
Polypoid에서 게임을 시작합니다.
All right, so top left, we have Flash. Still steaming and fuming from that last game. Bottom left, we have Queen.
Yeah, Queen really handling that last game very well. And I'll tell you, I mean, I think if Queen had a couple more lings, he might have been able to hold that push from Flash. But it also shows how perfectly Flash understands the game, where he knows exactly when to push out, even against four hatcheries, which is quite a bit of production. Mm-hmm. You know, he knew he had enough with the Vulks and the bio on the ground to tip the scale.
Yeah. I've heard, you know, that last map Horizon, like I said, I thought that would be the hardest map for Flash in the pool. He's definitely said some negative things about the map, about how difficult it really can be. And totally, you can kind of see that reflected, especially in those close by air spawns, right? It's just, what are you supposed to do there? That is a very tough situation. Now, Polypoid, this is going to play so much more normally. This is like a more interesting version of Fighting Spirit or something, where there's some additional terrain changes, some more interestingly placed bases. If we are going to have a long game, a long macro game, it should be this map.
I think you're right.
Yeah.
It does seem like most of the TVZs with Flash here don't go to late game very often.
Most of any of his games don't go to late game. Like, he just, you make a certain amount of mistakes and he kills you generally. Or you make you force enough mistakes out of him that he dies. Like, that's generally how it goes, because you don't want to. I mean, that's just how good he is, I guess, right? Like, and you don't want to just bring it into a later game generally, because it's not like he gets weaker at any stage in the game.
Yeah.
But there's mistakes cost more early on, like small mistakes, right? So that's like kind of, it makes sense when you think about it. But Flash here, once again, not going for any sort of mech play, not going for a quick gas at all.
No. No, it seems like he's intent on just getting his second base up, defending it, and then stretching the game out into one where he has some opportunities to push. Now, one thing about this map, since it is, you know, four corners are the four spawns here, there's a chance that Zerg tries to steer this into what is probably the most textbook TVZ over the ages, which is the Zerg's third base is in another main. They'll tech into Mutas and then tech into Lurkers after that to defend the ramp of the main and then go to Hive from there. And it's a perfectly good way to play on a map like this where, you know, there's just a lot of incentive for Zerg to play like that. But we'll see. I mean, especially with the games against Flash, and even when Flash is playing against these other Zerg players, there's so many mind games going on.
Mm-hmm. There is. And, like, in particular, you know, that's definitely the most common over the years expansion pattern that you mentioned, like Zero or Queen, sorry, in many games, ZBT would probably take that bottom right main in these spots. But there's a decent chance he'll take 6 o'clock, because if you're going to keep on heavy pressure with Mutas, it's going to be a closer rally. It's going to be, you know, closer to get drones to or from, Lings over to defend, things like that. So there's that possibility as well. It's a very standard timing here as far as the lair. Nothing too crazy. Okay, hold on. What's he going to make? What's he going to make? Factory again. Oh, it's so interesting. I think it's going to be the Valkyrie build. That's what it looks like to me. But okay. I can't tell you 100% right now. This is the thing about Flash, like mentioned, right? We've seen 9 tournament TBZs from him in the past week and a half. And, well, I guess now 11 when you count these two games he just played.
That's true.
Different builds every time.
Yeah. Now, but this game is looking very similar to Matchpoint. He has 2 SCVs, or had 2 SCVs out on the map to ensure that he would be able to scout. He did get in there. He did confirm it's going to be 2 hatch Mutalisk. We do have another drone that's out on the map. I'm assuming that's going to be throwing or turning into a hatch pretty soon here.
It's actually coming back. It may have been a little bit of a decoy. I didn't really see. Yeah, it could have been a rally. It could have been also if the SCV was standing there. Maybe he was like, oh, let me send this out like I'm expanding to make it look very normal.
So the starport is being produced now. Do we have a bunker? I thought we had a bunker, right?
I believe he has a bunker,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, he does. Okay. I'd be surprised if he didn't. Just you've got to be careful against mass lings.
Yeah, and actually, the time that he masses slings, this is a lot of Zerglings. Flash, I was telling you about it before the show, he has a new timing that he moves out at 450 with 9 Marines and 2 Medics, which is a fantastically strong build that we saw in KCM. He's not using it here, but Queen was ready in case that was it, because he doesn't know what this is yet.
So this is a really strong play here. You have 6 slings in the front, which is... It was speedlings, that's always enough to catch an SCV, but behind it you have many more lings.
If Flash moves out, dead.
Yeah.
But he's not moving out because he's teching up very quickly, which makes these lings pretty useless.
Can he make more lings? Is there any value in that? Because, you know, a Valkyrie doesn't help against lings at all.
This building placement that Flash has, you're not going to break it. It's just, by the time you get up there with the lings enough to try to break it, his SCVs will be on top of it repairing.
Oh, I really like this.
Oh! It's moves like that, though, can be tricky. Like, if Flash overcommits Marines walking to the right and, like, they aren't in the bunker or something, maybe you can sneak your way in.
So a lot of Zergs get up to 11 Mutalisks, but we'll have to see if he can identify. Frankly, I don't know that he can identify that it's actually Valkyries.
I think
this is, like, a way more... impenetrable location.
It's well hidden, but actually when he went up to the turrets, if you see one barracks with 2 more making, you know that there's tech behind. Because when the Mutas get here at this time, 3 barracks should be completed
already.
Would
he ever suspect a science vessel coming out instead? Would he ever think maybe he's rushing to irradiate?
Probably not. Like,
okay. Well, now he knows. So.
Generally, you can't get a science vessel that quickly. Like, it takes a lot longer to get that out, and then you get, like, one irradiate. If you're rushing up like that after such a quick command center, a lot of times it is Valkyrie. So this, again, though, this is not a super common build.
So is there a number of Valkyries you want to have before you push? Is it, like, three or four, or...?
More than one. One doesn't really do all that much. Okay. At two, they start to really punish Mutalisks.
Okay.
Obviously, we saw Flash getting three and then pushing, and then the fourth came, and then the fifth came, so it was, like, it was pretty excessive. But, yeah, you definitely need to wait for at least two.
So, well, let's just see. I mean, again, this game looks a lot like game one. We sort of ended up where both players are in the same situation. There's more Scourge being made. The idea is that the Scourge come in and knock the Valkyries out of the game, and then the Muta and then the Ling Muta can do the rest of the damage. The problem is that Valkyries will damage basically all the Mutas as the attack happens, and Stim Marines do damage quicker than pretty much anything and can target down other Marines pretty fast.
Oh, a Burrow play! I didn't even see that as an observer!
I didn't even see that either.
The Valkyries, though, showing their worth.
He can't even dive back in there at all. I mean, that's like it. He's going to get these overlords for free. I actually think Terran might just push through it and crush it.
Yeah.
I really like the burrowed Lings, but.
Yeah, no, that was a,
probably
that was a very
a
tricky
more,
play.
To be frank.
Yeah.
And I mean, the problem is that since Valkyries damage everything in that area they spray the missiles into, it's like everything's going to die if the Valkyries just get a few more shots
they
off.
They need one more volley, and most of the Mutas are gone.
Oh, yeah, here we go. Ow, ow, ow.
My god.
Okay.
Just everything dies. Well, that was a quick one-sided one. So, yeah, this is, like, I have seen some very quick Valkyrie into mass bio plays, but it seems like he has really fixed this build order up. Like, let me correct my speech here, right? This strategy is not super common. The build order he is doing, because build and strategy people use interchangeably a lot, it's actually, that's incorrect.
Yeah.
Because build is actually the order in which you are building your units at certain times.
Yeah.
This is Flash's build, okay? I've seen this strategy before, but it seems like he is getting his Valkyries a bit quicker. He's a little bit safer against everything. It looks very, very powerful, and I haven't seen this exact build, and I think maybe Zero hasn't either, the way that this is going against
him. The burrow was a good idea, but you need more Lings. I mean, when you have two hatcheries, you can't really get much of anything out. You know, I mean, you're getting the layer out so quickly. He just doesn't have, even, you know, had that been 12 Lings burrowed and they pop up, maybe he wins that fight. Maybe he knocks Terran back out, but, you know, he didn't take the fight. And then the Mutas were so low, it's like, okay, well, this is, it's basically impossible to ever confront the push that's coming from Flash. He has no sunken colonies, and Flash just wins that. So we are with Flash at a 2-1 lead. There's still a chance for Queen to take it, but he'll have to win the next two games in a row, which is a tall order against Flash, the most accomplished pro gamer of all time.
But you know what? We're going into Neo Silphid, a very comfortable map for everyone in the world, and then Hitchhiker, one where a superior strategy can end up winning over anything
else. I totally
agree
with you. I totally agree. Flash did say he feels stronger on map 4 and 5 compared to our first three maps. So I'm curious to see if he's going to have the same style of play or maybe even something completely different.
Yeah, I don't know, but this build looks so strong from Flash.
Yeah.
It's kind of making me excited to play the ladder tomorrow, man. A lot of Zergs are going to have to start going Lurker until they figure out how to stop this.
We have a short break, and we come back game number 4 on Neo Silphid.
울트라 기어로 부드럽게 이긴다. LG 울트라 기어 게이밍 모니터.
아, 취했나?
청정제주 숙취 비법과 탄산의 만남. 숙취엔 깨스강.
생일 아벨은 까먹으리라고 했는데 우리 아빠는 맨날 까먹어요.
라벨을 떼지 않아도 오키. 라벨을 없앤 아이시스 8.0 에코. 따는 순간 분리배출까지. 지구에게 오키, 모두에게 에코. 라벨이 없는 아이시스 8.0 에코.
숙취 이제 탄산으로. 청정제주 숙취 비법과 탄산의 만남. 숙취엔 깨스강.
그리고 아무도 없었다. 여러분은 소문으로만 존재하는 고스트라 불리는 테란의 특수 요원에 대해 알고 계신가요? 고스트는 상상할 수 없을 만큼 잔혹한 훈련을 통해 탄생한 인간 병기입니다. 훈련을 모두 통과한 고스트 요원들은 은신 기술이 탑재된 특수 군복과 기계화 부대를 한순간 무력화시킬 수 있는 락다운 장비, 천재지변급 공격을 지시할 수 있는 레이저 포인터를 지급받습니다. 아, 그거 말고요. 이러한 특수장비와 강력한 신체 능력을 두루 갖춘 고스트 요원들은 엄청난 명중률의 저격 능력과 끈질긴 생명력을 자랑하기 때문에 자치령 내부에선 지금도 비밀리에 이들의 양성을 진행하고 있는 것으로 알려졌습니다. 마침 여기 비밀 임무를 수행 중인 유령 요원을 발견했습니다. 적진에서 멀지 않은 거리. 고스트 요원은 클로킹을 시작합니다. 극한의 상황에서도 생존하는 굶주린 특수 요원에게 카카로는 아주 소중한 단백질원이죠. 식사를 마친 고스트 요원, 적진에 침투해 자신이 지금까지 배워온 자신의 존재 이유를 드러냅니다. 당하는 상대 진영에서는 귀신이 들렸다는 등의 소문과 함께 흉흉한 불안감이 조성됩니다. 고스트, 유령이라 불리는 까닭은 바로 여기에 있겠죠. 고스트 요원의 무서운 점은 여기에서 끝나지 않습니다. 정의 고스트 요원의 상징과도 같은 고출력 레이저 포인터. 그 무엇보다도 파괴적이고 강력한 공격이 개시됩니다.
공격이 감지되었습니다.
더 무서운 점은 자신 역시 흔적도 없이 사라져 고스트라는 자신의 정체성을 완성시킨다는 것이죠. 고스트 요원의 자폭 의도가 기밀 유지를 위한 희생이었는지 단순히 거리를 잘못 잰 건지 뭐 장비의 연구가 덜 된 것인지는 알 수 없지만 배터리 잔량만 있으면 보이지 않기 때문에 고스트는 비밀 요원으로서의 존엄성을 지키며 생을 마감합니다. 의도가 무엇이었든 결국 그곳엔 아무도 없었습니다.
울트라 기어로 선명하게 이긴다. LG 울트라 기어 게이밍 모니터.
What's up, everybody, guys? We are back at the ASL. And right now, I'm getting a little bit worried for Queen here. If he keeps teching into two hatch, we were just checking Twitter, and TT1 said something really interesting that maybe Flash actually made this build to try to force Zergs into going three hatch again.
Well, it's the hardest counter I've seen so far to the two hatch play, which has completely infested the matchup. Like, I would say, you know, I play so many games every week, and I would say like 90% plus is against two hatch when I play against Zerg. So, but the thing is, like, there's been a bunch of builds that have come out to try to counter this. Like, Flash has all sorts of different bio timings he's been using to try to force Zerg into a slight disadvantage. And then, of course, there is the new Goliath play that's been out for a while now that has kind of evolved over time a little bit to try to really counter them and be like, well, you can't really harass, right, because there's Goliaths with range here. So this, though, is like he's making so many Valkyries so quickly and then pushing out with bio. And you saw there, he wasn't microing. Ling's unburrowed under his army, none of it mattered.
By the way, I think the Ling Bro was a good idea.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
you need
yeah.
more Lings.
Yeah.
And you on two hats, you just can't get much of anything. I mean, you don't have a lot of drones. You're going into production so quickly. Yeah, I mean, maybe you do have to go for three hats or something like that. Because if it's just Medic Marine, Ling Muta can fight it. But when you have Valkyries, which just do so much damage to the Mutalists to begin with, if the infantry clean up the ground, then it's like... And we saw what happens when the Valkyries run away. The Mutalists run away from the Valkyries. That's when the damage really gets inflicted.
They get one more volley off? Oh, man.
Yeah, they get enough volleys off that then the Mutas are basically useless. So are we going to see Queen adjust from this? I don't know.
It's so hard to adjust during a best of five in a round of four when your opponent has brought something that hard counters probably what your entire planning sequence was. And this, again, shows the kind of level that Flash is at, that he can come up with something. He's like, oh, this erases the strategy that everyone uses. And he's
it's like because we've seen Valkyries used before, but not in this way. The fact that they're being teched into so heavily, it really forces the Zerg into dealing with this. It seems like again we've had another meta shift. It looks like it's happening right in front of our eyes here, but maybe two hatch is somewhat obsolete. Maybe this is just the shutdown strategy for any two hatch Shmita, which by the way. 2-hatch Muta is like the bread and butter build of ZVT.
It has been for like a year or so. It's about a year ago. It really started to switch over to 2-hatch from 3-hatch.
We've had three games where Valkyries have been teched into. So I also wonder if there's some strategy that Queen can use, some build that Queen can open with that just stops Valkyries from being effective at all. You know, is there any kind of lurker rush you can do? Can you make a spire fake them out?
Well, this particular build, I think the only way to truly counter it in this situation is his two SCVs you know are coming, right? You're able to think about this. So he's going to scout you. He scouts your Spire. You kill the SCV. You don't make Mutas. Not even joking here. don't make them. Because if he's going Valks, the thing is, the time he doesn't go Valks, then suddenly you're like sitting here on Lings, and he's like, "Oh no, I went three barracks right away, and I have two fire bats. Get out."
Also, the way that Flash plans for a best of five, he might even abandon this build.
Yeah,
could. He might say, "Okay, if you even beat me in one of these games, let's just throw this out. I have a whole lot of other styles." So,
yeah. Who knows, man?
Yeah.
It's Flash, and I'm just in awe because I already knew how good he was and talked him up, but then I'm like looking at this. I'm like, did you just figure out how to make this build not exist anymore?
It's crazy. You
actually just screw up every Zerg on Earth?
Our game's ready. The map's Neo Silphid. If Flash wins, he goes to the finals. If Queen wins, we're tied up 2-2.
네오실 PD에서 게임을 시작합니다.
오케이, okay, so at 12 o'clock is Queen. Down here to about 4 o'clock is Flash.
More like 420
Tasis. Nice. Nice, my favorite number. So let's see what Flash is going to do. I thought it was going to be more interesting to see how Queen would handle the matchup, but the fact that Flash has opened up with different variations of Valkyrie builds here from the two games where he just gets Valkyries out right away is really fascinating. Game two is the one that he actually shut him down with the mass meters, but that was also a positional play as well.
Yeah. Well, the positional play, on Horizon. That was a weird build that Flash ended up having to use. I don't think it was very good. But I don't think we'll see that again. He's spoken to how tough Horizon can be. But Neo Silphid, this is a map that everyone plays all the time.
Right.
I think I probably play more games here than Fighting Spirit nowadays.
I think this is the best map that's out right now. I think that...
Yeah, it's a great map.
I think we should maybe encourage a few more really solid maps like this. Mm-hmm. You know, different expansion locations... Because these are maps that you can still play and learn on.
Three-player maps in general, I think, give you a better time in a lot of ways. This was Overpool, by the way. But yeah, the three-player maps, like the fact that they can't really be split.
You never have
one
cross spawns.
My favorite. Yeah. Yeah, there's never cross spawns. They can't be split. Those are two really fantastic things about them when you think about it, because that's some of the randomness in cross spawns. Like, there's a whole host of build orders where if, like, you choose it before anyone can be scouted, and then if it's cross spawns, you're either happy or unhappy. You know?
It's why a lot of players will occasionally cross spawn scout first on four player maps, just because they need to have an idea of what kind of game they're getting into. Yeah. If they're not in the cross spawn, then you just try to play the safer way. If they're, you know, either whichever other spawn they're in, that's closer to you, of course.
Yeah, three-player maps are great when they're made well, like Sylphid. Can't even think of other really good ones. Okay, so Flash going ahead and scouting him right off the bat, and it looks like he's going to go 15 command center here. But this was Overpool, so he's going to see that probably some Zerglings are making. How many, though?
Yeah, we have the first two out. Now it's four.
And what he's doing right here is trying to block the Zerglings, because he played a very greedy opener with the 15 command center. That is a command center before any Marines and before a second depot.
Right.
So what he's going to have to do here, he likely has to cut an SCV or two, because he has to get a bunker and a depot right now and a second Marine at least.
But he'll get this up in time, right?
Yeah, the bunker will be up. But he's going to have to bring SCVs to help block the Zerglings from running into his base.
By the way, when the Zerg is committing to this many Lings right away...
Oh, he's not actually going to bring up anything. I guess he's decided that four Lings are not going to risk running by a two Marine bunker. But look, this was... Queen lightly punished what Flash opened with there.
Yeah.
That was nice.
Now he's got to get rid of the SCV. The Layer is chugging along here. But Layer Tech would be ideal for the Zerg to just stop. The scouting of the SCV to keep the Terran guessing, you know, is it going to be a Spire? Maybe it's a surprise Hydra Den. All these things are incredibly important, so.
Well, the SCV still alive, still scouting, checking out what's what. Goes to the natural. You can stop it from going back in. He has a second SCV sent out on the map as well, by the way.
Yeah, every game Flash keeps a second SCV out here. And we have the first den. And, well, you know, I'm... Okay, hold on. There's a Ling that can spot to see this SCV.
Yeah.
Now, he needs to turn around, like, now.
Well, he needs to bring a drone to his little hole to stop this from getting in. Because if you see the Hydralis den...
Link's done. He should be able to get this... Okay,
he actually blocks the scouting, and that SCV, I'm not sure if it saw the Spire. It may have just barely. We didn't
switch
vision.
But I think the Spire looked like it was a little bit late if he did see it.
Yes,
That actually might have been better to not make that. I don't know. These are, like, the two best players in the world right now playing. But you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
I mean, the Layer always comes down exactly at the same moment with two hatch.
Yeah, so. This is, like... Okay, he's actually making a Vulture and a second factory. Wow. So he's actually bending his build order right now, because this looked very much like the previous builds that we saw.
Right.
I think the Vulture is to force its way out to check what's going on. And he goes add on behind it. So this is exactly what's going on here, I think.
Now,
maybe not. It's just sitting there.
Let's see where the Hydras are going to be made here.
This is wild, man.
Yeah, this is
There
crazy.
Are so many little things going on right here. Like this SCV, he needs to poke out. He knows that Queen could be hiding something, and Queen knows that. So it's this little kind of mind game going on. Oh my god, he's just going to go with a Ling Hydra bust.
Oh, is it not Lurkers at all?
I don't think so, Tasteless. Like, he's just got these Hydras sitting there.
I think he's maybe waiting for Hydra speed to finish or something.
Lurker would actually just kill him.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Okay, it is
Lurker. Get the other Lurker!
There is a possibility that he can just kill him with this. But there's two factories being made, and Lurker Ling is not good against mech unless you get them without detection. That's, like, the only situation where the mech is in trouble.
Okay. He'll have three Lurkers and a fourth one just a little bit later on, but he needs to get in there right now.
Ooh.
Here we go.
Oh, my God. I don't know if Flash is going to be able to hold this. He gets around that bunker in a matter of seconds. Definitely not enough here to fight off that entire Zerg army.
And now he's going to try to push through here. The Lurkers can leapfrog, opening up access over here to the natural. The SCVs have to be sacrificed just to buy time.
Yeah, he does need to buy that time. He's bringing SCVs up right now. He needs to block those Lurkers. They can't get any further. The Lings on top of the Goliaths right now. Goliaths can be microed against Lings heavily, and he is doing that. But so many SCVs have already fallen.
GG, he taps out.
Ooh, game five coming
yes.
up. All right.
Great play by Queen.
So Queen, he has just innovated on the spot, figured out a way to beat the build that Flash was trying to go for. He blocked Flash's scouting. Flash was unable to tell exactly what it was. We saw Flash change the build a little bit from what we were seeing before. He didn't go into Starport. He went into a second fact.
And here we are again. Flash is one game away from being knocked out as the competition is catching up and catching up. Now, of course, I don't think the Queen can do that build again, but I'm not counting anything out here. I mean, that was a build where he went for the two factories again, like a little bit like we saw in game two.
Yeah, it was like that. It was like that quite a bit.
I wasn't really watching for Valkyries after that or Mass Barracks after that, but he's been oscillating between two build orders. Where do we go? I forgot what map five is all of a sudden. What is it?
Hitchhiker.
Okay, so this is a completely insane map.
This is a completely strategic map.
Yeah.
Mechanics don't even really matter here. Like, you don't have to have that great of macro. Micro definitely can come into play. It's a Mutalisk playground if you try, like, bio or something, but that's unlikely. There's definitely a lot of rushing that takes place on the map. If you do not do a very sharp timing that kills your opponent while they're off guard, then the game goes long because it's just so hard to move around.
Man, I'm so excited for Game 5. I can't believe how good this season of ASL is.
It's amazing.
It's so crazy.
Just the fact that right now, like, watching Flash bring out a two-hatch Mutalisk back-breaking build order, and then by the third time he's doing it, Queen counter it and win, bring us a Game 5? This is wonderful.
We're going to go to a short break, and when we come back, the final match on Hitchhiker between Flash versus Queen, a fight to get to the finals of the ASL.
Ultra기어로 부드럽게 이긴다. LG 울트라기어 게이밍 모니터.
라벨 떼고 버려야 되는 건 알죠? 근데 귀찮아서 잘 안 해요.
라벨을 떼지 않아도 오키. 라벨을 없앤 아이시스 8.0 에코. 따는 순간 분리 배출까지. 지구에게 오키, 모두에게 에코. 라벨이 없는 아이시스 8.0 에코.
당신 뭐 핫식스 토킹 아세요?
핫식스 뭐요?
핫식스 토킹.
이거 정말로 맛있는데 아.
제가 오늘 핫식스 토킹 먹으면 당신은 저한테 빨릴 거예요. 아세요?
아, 이런 악마의 음료. 이걸 빠시다니.
그리고 핫식스 토킹 그 빨간 제품 있거든요. 열대 과일 맛이 나요. 열대 과일 맛.
자신 있으세요?
울트라 기어로 선명하게 이긴다. LG 울트라 기어 게이밍 모니터.
Guys, this ASL just keeps getting better and better. It's
good. Yeah.
We're gonna go to game five with Flash versus Queen. And you know, I love what Queen did there on game four, but we're on Hitchhiker, which is a completely insane map. It is. Well, I guess we could talk about it when we actually get into the map, because it's such a weird map. But all the stuff we've had leading up to this, I don't think is going to be telegraphing the changes that we might see from the players in game five. I mean, you really have to play your Hitchhiker game and then move on from there.
It's a completely different map. It requires a completely different way to play. And I mean, I think a lot of this is just going to be in the opening builds, what they choose to do. What is your strategy going in here? Are we going to see a quick rush on either side?
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Is anyone going to play a defensive game? It's a very tricky technical map,
and
it's very hard to predict.
I can't imagine what's going on in the minds of these guys. I mean, this has been such a close series. By the way, these Zergs are showing that they can get just close enough to almost kill Flash.
Yeah, well, you see the amount of mind games going on here is absurd. It's
crazy.
So back and forth with that, you know, an amazing series in that way. It's very different from a lot of series that people like, where it's just like purely mechanical, like, whoa, big armies. It's like, no. This is all very technical.
Different game. Game five has loaded up. Let's do Flash versus Queen, the last match, decide who goes on to the ASL finals.
Hitchhiker에서 게임을 시작합니다.
So this is a one-on-one map. I actually said earlier on the match point, I'm like, that's the last one-on-one map. Then I get here now, and I'm like, oh,
you?
That's right. Sorry, guys.
That's funny.
Hitchhiker is so weird. I don't think of it normally like that. I'm more obsessed with the geography of the map. So this map, you have a natural on your low ground, and then there's a very narrow valley that leads directly in a beeline to your opponent's base.
Feels more like a ditch than a valley, but continue.
Yeah. So the other thing is that inside your main, you also are granted about, I don't know, 40% of the rest of the map.
Yeah.
You have access to.
Yeah.
There's destructible temples that they can also tear through to get access to that. And we don't normally have like really, really long games here. I think if we played on this map for years and years and years and years and years more, maybe we would have more normal long games. But right now, this map seems so crazy. We have a lot of explosive things that happen right away.
There's a lot of ways to sneak in and get a lot of damage done. So it's comes down a lot to very technical openings and who has planned better for the game than their opponent. I don't know what to expect between these two.
I this matchup as well, I'm completely out of my element on this map. I just don't know. Do you have this, do you play this on ladder?
I try to, but it's just about everyone vetoes it.
Yeah,
I get it.
It's vetoed for me personally.
I play maybe one game a week on Hitchhiker. And That's probably pretty evenly split between random players and Protoss players. So that kind of shows you the type of map it is. It's just
seems
a
like
cheesy,
Protoss would be
cheesy
pretty, pretty good, actually, on this map.
Yeah, yeah. There's all sorts of things you can do. Now, look at where he put his barracks. That is already very, very weird where he hit.
Yeah, that's in the very bottom right. Zerg went for a pool and gas.
He might be trying to fake something like it's out on the map or being floated somewhere, or I'm not sure. That's definitely weird. He's going to go ahead and expand really quickly on the high ground. That's interesting.
Huh. Okay. So as we were saying, you're gifted about 40% of the map just inside your main. The only way they can get to you early on is by up your ramp. So, I mean, this is safe. I actually didn't think Flash was going to play like this, but
no.
I welcome it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I thought, but this seems to be like, a very passive, I pretty much know how to hold everything type of play.
Especially since that is a mineral base. Because that's a mineral base, like that just means that is if Queen doesn't attack him super heavily early on, we should have a long game.
Right. But, you know, Queen went for the very quick pull. One thing that Terrans do like to do on this map is do a lot of very, you know, if the Zerg tries to expand, we've seen Bunker Rushes be very popular here. Very easy
to
push.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, so, it's, you know, that's, like, for instance, Light, the second best Terran. If we see him play this, he likes to 8-racks here.
He will
straight up 8-racks into a Vessel Rush every game against Zerg on this map.
And I actually thought we were going to have that, so it's kind of cool to see the very withdrawn approach.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, no, I'm just going to get my free base up, and I'll see you in mid-game, brother.
Well, let's talk about what this does, right? Because you have the gas expand down the ramp, but it's a very wide open natural. So things like Lings, things like Lurkers could be difficult to defend. Taking that mineral base, sure, you don't have that second gas, but you're gonna have plenty of minerals for things like turrets, and you don't have to defend against Lurkers, and you don't have to defend against Lings, because all like one bunker at the top of your ramp, and you're safe, and that's it.
Everything else at a ramp, it's like Zerg's just not gonna get up there. Now,
never.
That being said, you know, has Zerg actually scouted the Sartosis? I don't know that he has.
He has not seen it.
And it's actually a pretty long way to scout. I mean, it's something you could definitely suspect would be coming, right? But
yeah.
I think that having the confirmation of that versus any kind of crazy tech is pretty huge. Now, also, I want to point out, the gap between the main and this mineral-only base that Flash has taken is very big. And it's not easy to maneuver Marines through there. They move through a straight line, which Mutalisks can abuse pretty easily. Mm-hmm. It's also, you have the predicament that you certain races and certain matchups have to deal with where they have a main, a natural, but then the access point, a third position to defend, mm-hmm. which usually means they're stretched pretty thin. Mm-hmm.
So this is the Valkyrie build again from Flash, which I guess that makes sense because you don't need that much gas to do this build. And he's safer against things like what Queen did last game. Like, Queen can't do that same build. Where you're going to get up that ramp? Okay, let's see you try.
Yeah.
Wow. And actually, Queen was making both a Hydralisk Den and a Spire, and he canceled the Den. Now, Flash is making a bunker there. He can make a turret there, so that would stop any Lurker play.
Check it out, Armory.
Oh,
wait. Whoa. Wait, what happened?
I think just
he accidentally canceled the control tower.
Yeah, that was weird.
Yeah.
Don't see that every day.
Well, definitely not from Flash usually, but...
Oh God, no wonder he said he was so confident here. Because, like, the more you look at this layout, it's like, yeah, nothing can kill him. Nothing.
Yeah, well, not just
if you put a turret next to that bunker, it's done.
Yeah, I mean, it's... What are you going to do? Especially
make a lot
with
of sunken so he doesn't kill you.
Yeah, Flash is looking with each sequence of the build lined up with what Queen's doing. He seems to be in a better spot, but let's see how much damage he can actually do. You know, there is a pretty naked area between the first base and the second base where you could snipe a Valkyrie with Scourge. It's not like a turret ring around everything. So,
well, he's got three or four turrets here, so that's enough for the first set of mutas that come out.
I think he's going to have to make quite a bit of turrets here. Now, can he make Lurkers and try to dig his way through the map through the left side?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Like, well, I think he wouldn't get on the offensive. I think he'd use that defensively because Yeah, and see, that does look like what he's doing. He has a couple creeps already ready. So now that he's seen this, I think what he'll do is play very defensively and just focus on getting a good economy up. Obviously, the Valkyries won't be all that useful against the Lurker tech. And as soon as you have a few Lurkers in the center, like, Bio does not break that anymore. But notice that Flash looks to be making a siege tank.
I love the eBay over the SCVs on the minerals.
Mm-hmm.
He's so perfect.
Yeah, he's making it very hard to micro there. And you can attack the eBay and get the glaives, but this works very differently against the Valks, because the Valks will come up and murder the Mutas.
Yeah.
Whereas if you were pure Bio, for instance, then they could just not be murdered.
Well said, Artosis.
Yeah. Yeah. People ask me about this all the time. Why don't you float buildings? It's like, well, there are situations like this where it does work.
Okay, every time the Mutas glide by, they eat a certain amount of damage. There's a tank out here as well, which I think means we might end up with a push.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, great snipe. Great snipe there, taking out one Valkyrie. Now keep in mind, if you're making Valkyries, you're not getting science vessels, okay? I mean, if you're making, kind of like with Protoss and Aropo, whatever you're making there, you're not getting some other kind of tech, you know? And so, you know, maybe Lurkers, when they come into play, depending on how many scans Terran has, could be pretty strong. And
yeah.
It seems like we're going to have a push come here. I mean, two tanks out.
You know what? In a situation where you know there's not vessels, hold position Lurker becomes the ultimate. But he
absolutely
doesn't have time for that, so you see him pushing these Sunkens forward. And this is a very common thing against quick tank pushes.
Yeah.
If you can just slow them down, that does a lot, because the Siege, the Unsiege, they'll kill those things, but it takes a while.
You can see Queen has to be very careful when he gets close here. I love just taking out the SCV that's going to come in here and maybe try to help repair or reinforce. Do we have Lurker eggs out yet?
I haven't seen
no.
any.
No. He's actually going to go for more Mutas.
Oh.
He's actually pocketing the
yes.
rest of the Mutas to make it look like he's going to tech into Hydras.
He's
going to
try to sandwich this, like hit the Valks with Scourge, and if he can Scourge all the Valkyries, he can kill the army with his Mutas.
Okay, every Marine he kills off. Oh, wait, did that connect?
I think one of the Valkyries took one hit,
okay.
I believe.
Oh my god, dude. Dude, he might just smother this.
He might. He
Here
needs
we
to kill the Valks
go.
Immediately, though.
He's going to come from below. Wait, what is he doing? Is he going to engage this from behind? Because he doesn't want the Valkyries to be able to run back home. He wants them to just run into the Zerg base and die.
Aww. Okay, he did a sweep looking for reinforcements, I think. And the Overlord saw this, so this is a beautiful pickoff.
Oh, easy mode there for Queen. Beautiful play. But he has to respond to this push. I think we might do
he
this.
He broke down the temples, and he's actually counterattacking into the mineral-only
base. Oh, my God.
Queen is doing a great job right now. These Lings are going to catch Flash completely off guard,
and there's
I think.
Really not much to defend over here. I mean, SCVs are not great against Speedlings here. He comes in here. He's chased out some of this. That wasn't the bulk of his Scourge.
Dude, this looks good for Queen.
I think actually Flash might take this.
Flash?
I'm sorry, Queen. I don't know what's going on in my brain today. He's actually turning around. He's turning around.
Well, this is a terrible situation. He knows that he's just going to lose this army. The Sunken Colonies did their job. They stalled everything out. You know, he doesn't have an additional gas yet. He realizes that side of the map, his side, is opened up.
With a Valkyrie count low enough, he can just, I think, if he has enough Scourge here, yeah,
ooh.
I mean, you're just going to kill the Valkyries.
Yeah.
And then the Marines are just going to be too low in numbers.
All right, turns and fights here. That's about as good as he can do. But this base is going to be wiped out, it looks like.
Another Valkyrie. Eat some damage from that Scourge there. There's some more infantry coming through here. The bunker's done. He has something to try to help defend.
Yeah, and you can see the supply differences here. They're very, very close. And
yes.
that's tough for Terran. You definitely need a higher supply than Zerg to fight against them.
Okay, the CC's getting low. More Mutas are coming in here to reinforce. I actually think he's just going to lose the CC, which is pretty damn huge.
It's big. It is big. Oh my god, another Valkyrie getting picked off.
We have one more that's out, but you know, the Valkyrie count, it needs to be high enough to where so there it is again. Every time you see the Mutas retreat, they're going to eat a lot of damage. Does Terran know about this upper right base?
I think he does.
We saw the drop come up there, but I don't know if that was just intended for the main or what. He's going to get the eBay now, which is going to deny infantry upgrades, which infantry are the backbone right now of this game here.
This is looking terrible for Flash. Just terrible.
Could we have a repeat of what Snow did here? Queen knows he has an edge right now. He knows he can take it, but he has to make every decision perfectly from here on out.
Oh my God, I don't know how to defend this. There's just many meters.
There's just not much many turrets here.
There are not. But as he reduces that Scourge count.
Oh my God.
Yeah, he gets another one. And this is 3 Gas Muta. So this is getting really, really, really bad.
You can actually crush them under the Muta pressure. He comes in again.
Oh no.
And now this last Valkyrie's gone. I'm sure there's another one in production here. Oh my God.
He doesn't have enough, Tasteless.
He just doesn't have enough. There's just, the Glaives alone are going to just bounce off these Marines and kill them. There's one Valkyrie out. I mean, that was pretty good control. But there's more Mutas, more Scourge inbound here.
And look at this. He's trying to use the Valkyrie micro. He actually missed it like 4 times in a row. Finally gets a volley off.
Flash
and
is actually out. He's missed micro the Valkyries a couple times. You can see he's not quite as used to try to dodge Scourges.
It's a difficult one.
Very hard to do, yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, I think Flash is going to give up, man.
Oh, my God.
He is looking very hurt at the moment. So few turrets. He just finishes eBay. Another Valkyrie comes out, slides right into the Mutas, only gets 2 volleys off, doesn't even finish the second one.
The only thing that's really here is this one turret that's popping shots off. That's it, GG!
Whoa.
Queen defeats Flash.
Craziness.
In an insane upset. Oh my God.
Oh my God. And this means that Flash has only won half of the ASLs he's participated in. Is he going into a slump, everybody? Only a round of 4 against the best Zerg in the world? Oh, he's over. It's done.
Look at how happy Queen is,
too. This is huge for Queen. What a big moment.
Great play. It was those Lings getting into the main. Or that mineral only.
That was very nice. I feel like there was a couple things. First off, he went for the sunken push out to slow the siege tank push. But then he did not falter at all. He stayed on Muta Scourge. I do think against the strength of these Valkyries and the bio that Flash has been building here all day, many Zergs would have tried to get into Lurker. That's what I was suggesting.
Yeah.
But he stayed on the Scourge Muta and reduced the Valkyrie count repeatedly. And here he is. Queen goes to the finals.
Yeah, you get up to 3 or 4 Valkyries, even 5, and then the Mutas are not a threat. But he managed to assassinate each Valkyrie. He was very good with the Scourge. He was very patient, by the way. He popped off that drop instead of diving on the push. Mm-hmm. He knew he had enough sunken colonies to make it work. And we have just seen a god get taken down.
That's right.
Wow. So sick. That's so just sick. Incredible. Queen has now done what Snow has done. And we've seen Flash get eliminated. Just incredible.
Yeah, yeah, there's only been 4 people that have eliminated Flash from ASL, and that is Effort, Queen, Last, and Snow. And the Last and Snow ones don't even count. By Terran metrics, they don't even count, Tasteless. So here we are, just Zerg players able to do it against him.
Wow. So impressive. What a great series overall. We saw the players evolving. We saw Flash coming here with something to try to counter, to try to punish.
It was an amazing build. That build,
one of the most solid metas we've ever seen, is just 2-hatch Muta.
Yeah.
He says, I've got an answer for it. I can shut this down. But Queen navigated that line beautifully.
He really did. But you know what? I think that Flash just impacted the metagame of Terran versus Zerg so unbelievably heavily tonight, even though he lost, that I think we're going to see big changes. And in fact, Light is probably sitting there watching this. He's like, oh my God, I got to start practicing that build right this second.
Interview time. Congratulations, Queen. Thank you so much. So the you prepared for this matchup, and we got to Series 5. You focused, you kept it together. We could feel how close it was. How do you feel today, Win? I think my preparation went well. But a lot of the stuff that I wanted to do, I wasn't able to do because of the way he was opening. I think what I reacted to on map 4 and 5 was very helpful. So you defended Flash's attacks and counterattacks. I feel like because it's Flash, it's almost like you're going up against the final boss of ASL, and you did it, you won. Yeah, honestly, I'm glad I had the confidence to beat him. 솔직히 뭐 이런 말 해도 될지 모르겠는데 3대0
점까지도 생각을 했었거든요.
I thought that 네. if I win map 1, 아, I think I can 네, could maybe even beat him 3-0, but it's Flash, of course, it's Flash though, so he beat me in game 1. I was pretty discouraged. I struggled through the series, but I managed to come out on top.
결승전 반대쪽에 지금 기다리고 있는 선수가 박상현 선수 그리고 이재호 선수거든요. 개인적으로는 어떤 선수가 올라가나요?
So in the other semifinals, we have Light versus
저그 베테랑 그 종족이 다른
Choshim Zerg, Soma. Who do you want to face?
하지만 또 그런 부분들을 감안하지 않고 선택을 한다면요.
I don't think ZBZ is as fun as TBZ, so I would really prefer to face off against Light. I think more people would enjoy watching that. Honestly, Chosim Zerg, he's playing really well. I'm pretty uncomfortable facing off against him, too. But look, I beat Flash, so, you know, I took out a great tear, and if I can beat Flash, I think I can beat last, right? So you're saying if Light makes it to the finals, you're going to automatically advance? Basically saying, yeah, I am saying that. I mean, yeah, I'm that much confident, much more confident. He says, so maybe I should congratulate you in advance. He says, no, no, don't go that far. So anyways, I still have a chance to take off against Chosim Zerg. We've got to watch until the end. So there's a lot of fans and people have watched you and supported you. Any words to them? There are a lot of Terran players who helped me prep for today. Sorry I couldn't play the games that we had practiced because Flash's play was so different. But I'm grateful for the help nonetheless. Thanks again to Mind and the rest of the Terran players. Also all the fans who supported me. Even if I made it to the finals. So anyway, since I made it to the finals, it's really important for me to win. Actually, before we start this season, I try to really invest myself and focus on the games, but now that I'm here, I'm going to have to do my best to win it for everybody. Well, congratulations again, Queen. He says thank you. Damn, dude.
Great series. Great
really
series.
Special series.
So much back and forth, so many mind games and build order counters going on. A big day here for Queen. Of course, we saw that little video of him losing to Flash in the MSL before. That was almost 9 years ago.
Yeah.
But he's back to a finals now.
That's right.
And he is looking stronger than ever.
This is so crazy. What an exciting result to have here. You know, yeah. It goes to show you again, that's how competitive StarCraft is right now.
Yeah. Yeah.
You can actually just
You can
have
bring a metagame breaking build order that your opponent has never seen is to lose to him when you're the greatest player of all time.
Yeah.
Like, that's how strong so these guys are. It's
crazy. Crazy, man.
That was awesome. Like,
it was a treat.
Yeah, watching Zero's decision-making during some of these situations, just a treat for sure.
Wow. So now we have one day off, which I'll be streaming for tomorrow, so you guys should join me.
As well, of course.
Twitch.tv.
Monday, my
favorite
day.
/TastelessTV. My favorite day.
Yeah. Well, because
I love Mondays.
I do. My week hasn't been ruined by bad ladder sessions yet, so a wonderful start to the week.
Hang out with us tomorrow on our streams while we grind, and then come back on Tuesday because we have another T versus Zed,
yeah.
My friends.
And that's going to be funny because this match will heavily influence that. It didn't have to until Flash introduced that build. I guarantee you, Light is writing that build order down right now and thinking about it and be like, oh.
He's getting it tattooed on his legs, okay? So he can look down and just see the build.
Yeah, I was
back
thinking
up
about that. What if you tattooed, like, your best build orders on your hands and stuff? But it's like, well, why don't you just remember it instead? Then the metagame changes and you have to get it erased and, like, rewritten. Like, come on.
You're like, yeah, at that time it was like one base Sarah Reaver. It was really good, but nobody knew how to play that. And now everybody that could see my hand sees the build.
All right, slightly different map pool. Escalade is going to be in it in a slightly different set of or order of maps. Yeah, that's going to be a good one. I think that they absolutely can go either way. They're both in tip-top shape right now. And Light is the second best Terran vs. Zerg player in the world, and Choshim is the best or second best Zerg vs. Terran player in the world.
And this makes it a real toss-up for who takes it, no matter what, who we have in the finals. I was getting so used to just saying, well, look, Flash will probably take it, but you never know. But now here we are. He got knocked out. He's already out. He's dead. Yeah.
And that doesn't mean that Queen wins the finals anyways.
No.
Even if it's against Light, because Light plays Terran vs. Zerg quite differently than Flash.
Yes.
He's much more biocentric.
And he's looking better than he's ever looked.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, he's things are not slowing down. In fact, they are just ramping up more and more.
He's God mode right now. So this is going to be a great match. I'm very, very excited for it.
And Chosum, taking out the likes of Bisou with just insane decisive play. Really
that
stopping
was a great
the game.
Series. That was the best series that last round.
That was so crazy. Yeah, yeah. And I mean, it was just like, I'm not playing a macro game against Bisou.
You fool.
He's laughing so hard. He's crying. There's milk coming out of his nose. He
and
can't
his eyes because he
like,
cries milk.
Yeah. I'm not going to play macro games. I'm not going to see what Psystorm looks like in these games. Oh, my God. I'm just a jerk. I make hiders and kill you before the game starts. Stop. I can't breathe.
Oh, my God. And then Luke Skywalker comes over and gets some of the milk out of his nose to drink. I'm like, yeah, full circle. All right.
Wow, that was a really great series we had. I mean, the round
that
of eight
was
great, and now the first best of five in the round of four was amazing. And we had the upset that Flash actually lost.
Yeah, yeah. It's that's a very cool build, man.
We should also remind you as well that we have GSL Code S on Wednesday. So join
that's
us
right,
on Tuesday,
right.
And
so
then we're going to be back
Wednesday.
Evening time again, Korea, for GSL. So we're getting all of our tournaments in there. Mm-hmm. StarCraft II had a long hiatus where we hardly had any work, but now we're back, and we have a lot of work and a lot of casts, a lot of games to bring you guys.
Yeah, it's very, very fun. And, of course, ASL will be finishing up this month. And the finals, I believe we said, was on the 24th.
I think that's right.
Yeah. So, great stuff.
What a great last game. Hmm. And you know what? You were right. It came down to the strategy. Who had a better strategy?
Yeah. Yeah. Some very decisive plays and some very brave plays, too.
He welcomed the push.
Against, yeah.
He said, that's fine. I have
you
enough
You spend that one geyser on siege tanks?
Yeah.
Like,
this
okay.
is Hitchhiker. It's a much more difficult map to control. Mm-hmm. You can't have your army easily come back and defend. In fact, that mineral base is so far away from where that push is. Mm-hmm. And that's all it took.
Yeah. Well, very much fun. Can't wait to see what Queen is going to do in the finals. But first, I got to really hope that we got Light to win on Tuesday. So we have two great TVZs to look forward
to.
Yeah,
but I mean, I think the ZVZs will be really fun, too, if
yeah.
we have them. I mean, I don't like that people dog on mirror matchups too much because, like,
mirrors are good.
Mirrors
as long
are
as
very
it's not PvP on Gladiator, it's good. You
PvP
like Gladiator here. PvP?
Not playing it, but I like watching really good people play on it.
Ardosis. On Gladiator?
Yeah. Tasteless.
Tasteless.
You don't like that, tasteless.
You think it's like that, but it's not
it's
tasteless.
Not. You say it's this way, but it's that way, tasteless. No, I mean, I think when you get the best players of any race, it's like, let's see what they do. You know, let's see where the game goes.
Yeah, yeah. But, you know, that ZVZ we had between Larva and Queen was actually fantastic.
Yeah,
that
was great.
A really good one to watch.
Yeah.
So if we got another one like that, I would be quite happy about it.
Sure.
Yeah. And we're doing – are we doing best of five or best of seven finals? I'm actually
I can't
not
remember.
Sure.
I think we did best of fives at points in time, and then we did best of sevens.
Yeah, we did best
right?
of seven last season, so I'm pretty
sure
we
had
best seven
semifinals where there were best of sevens, and then we went back to best of fives for this one. I'm actually not sure.
Yeah, I think it's a best of seven because we had best of seven finals last season. Best of seven ZVZ would mean we'd see all the maps, so that would be pretty crazy.
Yeah, that's true. We do get all the maps out that way. But no, didn't we have? Oh no, we did have. Yeah, the best of seven finals for sure in ASL. Yeah.
Yeah, because it was the 4-0s. Like,
do you think
God.
We should have best of sevens or best of fives?
Best of fives are better.
I think best of fives are actually better.
Yeah, but for Brood War, best of five is better. Like you're going to get the better player to win generally in the best of five.
Yeah. It's also, statistically, you're more likely to have a close series.
3-1 is close.
4-1
is not close.
4-3 is so rare.
Yeah.
StarCraft 2 is a very good example.
When
you
get 4-3, it's like, wow! Mind explode.
Yeah.
But, yeah, when you get
4-1. Like less than 10% of the time.
4-1 is like, you look at that, you're like.
We could have had a 3-1.
Because it always goes like this. It goes 3-0, 3-1, 4-1, and
there's
you're like,
kids tweeting us right now, why don't you guys have best of 11 XD? It's like,
yeah.
It's like, we don't need to have that many games
yeah.
to decide.
It's okay for
it's okay.
there to be slight
can
upsets.
We have best to 100 XD? Yeah, I think best of 5 is usually better. It's just better TV. It's StarCraft 2 is a faster game, so we can fit more games in there. So it's like
there's
okay,
it's
well.
Also a little bit more volatile, I think. Mm-hmm. So having a bigger series is a little bit better because
mm-hmm.
it lets you iron that out. Whereas, yeah, I mean, we still have volatility in StarCraft 1, but at the super high level, it's not as often that we get any sort of upset. Like, even though this was like a slight upset, it, you know, that's fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's oh, I'm excited. And the thing is, I think no matter what now, we don't have any more one-sided games. I thought that the round of 8 was getting too good and it was going to be hard to match because, you know, it's like
yeah, what
every
if we
game went 3-2 to game 5.
The next one, too.
We could. We
what
totally
if it's just
could.
Just 3-2s for the rest of time.
Yeah.
We have best of ones that are 3-2s. It's like, what?
Yeah. So how do we do that?
Yeah, I don't even know. And so it just keeps getting better.
It's looking like it, man. Watch out. Zerg players on the ladder. Every Terran's making Valkyries right now.
I think so. I'm debating whether I want to rip that build tonight.
You want to rip that build tonight, Ertosis.
Kinda.
You're going to do it.
I think I might.
Yeah.
I think I might. And then I'm going to run into Lurker a bunch of times and lose all my points.
Yeah.
And be like,
no!
Everyone else
not
watched
fair!
It too! Yeah.
Okay. So we're just going to have this camera keep on running.
Have you ever had a staring contest with a camera, Tasteless?
This is the story of my life. I just keep staring at that little man I see in the camera.
Yeah?
That's
do you
me.
See your reflection in there?
Mm-hmm.
I don't see it.
Just that's a because, little, that's tiny because you're a ghost, Artosis. You've been dead this
I'm
whole
a vampire
time.
Or
yeah,
something.
This is a haunted studio, and yeah. I'm actually casting to nobody here.
That's what people would have you believe.
This game is so dead.
Yeah. LOL.
LOL. Everybody plays Fortnite now. Aren't you embarrassed? You play the hard game. You can't even Fortnite dance in Brood War.
People sing that to me all the time.
I know.
They're always singing yeah. that to me.
My favorite is people are like, nobody plays that game anymore. I'm like, well, that's literally not true. Mm-hmm. You don't play that game anymore because you play the new game that comes out every 6 months and it changes.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, most people want to sign up for the new cult. They're like, oh, there's a new eSport. Everyone go to it. Let's do it all together. Wow,
yeah.
It's so big.
Wow.
I want to be famous and rich.
The best player who won 3 months in is a legend.
I know. People
are talking about Overwatch teams. Like, those guys are really good. I'm like, this
dude.
Game is, like, so new.
When I see people like, the legend. This guy's a legend. I saw that being tweeted, like, years ago. And I'm like.
A legend?
A legend?
A legend?
We've been playing the game professionally
yeah.
for a year, and we have someone at legend status?
Yeah. Wow.
I hope he hit everyone in the head on his first shot and never got hit.
Yeah. He hopped around a lot when he did it.
Yeah.
I hope. It seemed
wow.
Seemed like him and his teammate casted all the ultras at the same time, didn't they?
Damn.
Nah, this is the badass hardcore esport. StarCraft
yeah,
1,
really
StarCraft
is.
2. Other esports are fine, but, man, this is the one that started it all, and you could see why with these games.
Well. It takes the utmost of skill.
Yeah.
These people are so ludicrously good. The thing is, I sit here and it's like a word salad starts coming out of my mouth while I try to take 22 years of StarCraft experience of devoting my life to it and put into words what even I see as the mind games, and there's even more behind that. And it's like, oh my God, this is just
mwah.
Beautiful. Mouthfeel 100%.
So
dude,
good.
My mouth is full of silk and chocolate pudding. It is the best mouthfeel you could ever get. Can you think of something better?
Yeah.
What?
Chocolate
silk
pudding.
Is so soft.
I just seeing you at home in your underwear just stuffing chocolate pudding in your mouth. It's like all over your tree. You're like, oh, the mouthfeel.
Yeah. What?
Like, okay, brown mouth. Have fun.
Brown mouth.
Old brown mouth over here.
That's what my wife calls me, brown mouth.
Wow, orthosis.
And I'm wiping my mouth with silk. I'm like, yeah. I have a like special
my
silk
mouth
napkin.
Like it's just full of candy corn. It's so good. That's all the time we have, guys. Now we have to finally wrap it up. We love you guys. We'll see you on Tuesday. We'll also see you on Monday because we're going to be streaming tomorrow. Have a good morning, afternoon, or night, wherever you are.
ASL Season 9 Refresher. 100,000